During 13 years, they got one child, right? But his, the children, their child name is Yuran. So, after they got, I think, when his wife was born, when after he knew that his wife got, you know, give given a child. At that night, so he thought, oh, because during that day, he go in the garden, and he saw four signs that is make his to, you know, to get rid of the, from the holy family lives to search the truth. That four signs was what four signs is. That he first he saw the sick man and dead and you know sick and what dead person old person. So when we saw when he saw that he realized because he realized that oh this world is important one day I also will be like that. And finally he saw that some recluse sitting under the tree and he asked his fellowship his son what is that person. Then he said that that is a recluse. He practiced to, you know, realize the peace and to get rid of the suffering. Something like that. He explained about recluse. So he interested. He want to be like that. Then at the night, he left from his parents. Go to in the jungle with his horse and with his one of his fellows that is named Sanna. So he left after he got one child. At that night he left to the jungle and searched for the truth, practice. So after that, he practiced in order to become, to realize the nature, the Dhamma, to become a Buddha. He practiced 6 years because at that time he, you know, he didn't realize the way how to practice. So before that he practiced very, you know, strict. He trying to, you know, he cannot realize the truth during 6 years. But finally, there is one God and come and show the way. He bring that. We call Gita, some K guitar, right? If maybe string, if you put very, you know, very strong, that is not nice to listen, and very loose. So loose is not also not nice to listen. So that's middle. That is he showed, and he showed the way how to practice. So when he realized that, oh, I have to go to that self-indulgence and self-modification. These two way is cannot you know, it's not good way. So he followed the middle way, not too indulgent, not to sort of modificate. Yeah, that is his way. The Buddha way is middle way. So now, so after that, when he received food from Suchada, one woman named Suchada, because at that time she wanted a child, so she go and pray for God tree that maybe they believe that in one a big tree we have one God, and she go and pray and for asking for a child. So coincidentally, the Buddha will know that the Buddha go and sit at under the tree. So when she saw the Buddha, at that time Buddha is not Buddha yet, right? That's his name. He's not become a Buddha yet. Mm-hmm. Just that woman think that that is or what she want to see, and that this God, some kind of God, so she offers rice meal to Buddha. After the Buddha having that rice meal, and he practiced at not very soon, so he become a Buddha, very just. So the Buddha now he practiced Zen meditation. Then he realized inner peace, the nature, what happened. So he realized by himself, he knows about all the nature, what happened. So he declared himself, now I know everything now. At first, he declared that because many lives he just surrounding in the samsara around the world. Sometime he was born as an animal, sometimes he was born as a god, sometimes as a human being, just surrounding. It says his life go rounding in this world. So many lives. So finally, because at that time he doesn't know how to get rid of from this sensor, then this in sensor in Pali. Some of you know that.
Reincarnation?
Yeah.
Reincarnation.
That's, yeah, connection. So that is the last life for him. So he will never reborn again, but his teaching still remain now. That's why the way of the Buddha practice is now we call Buddhism, right? And the one who follow his way, we call Buddhist. So in Buddhism we have three kinds, that is a tribulation. We call tribulation. What versus the Buddha, his teaching, or Dhamma, and the community of monks and people, Sangha, as us. So, and when we talk about his Dhamma, he has thought at that time 48,000 Dhammaskandha, 48,000 teachings he has taught. And when they cry, you know, because at that time no how to say support this kind is mixed up when he taught, when during his 45 years, during his 45 years the Buddha has go anywhere teaching, preaching to other people, and you know, he went everywhere around that India at that time. During 45 years, he has taught, that is, so many kinds of, because due to the people understand, their habitual help, because he knows that if I want to, you know, give a Dhamma talk to you, I know your I can read your doubt. What kind of example? How to you know, how to talk Dhamma so you can realize, you can understand like that. So he has used so many kinds of examples. That's why the Dhamma become very many. So at that time, when the time of the Buddha, there is the Dhamma, it's mixed. After he has passed away, there is a they have 3 months after he's passed away, and all the monks together and trying to make the Buddha's teaching three kinds. Suppose some kind it will be about the room, some kind about philosophy, some kind of the ethic, something like that. So that's why become a three bitter girl, or it means three baskets.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And one is Vinaya. Vinaya is the rule or the code of the monastic. And Sutta, that is the about the you know ethic. Abhidhamma is the about philosophy, the Buddha philosophy. And when we talk Sangha, so now we, after 100 second Buddhist Council, there is separate into two groups. We call Hinayana and Mahayana. Hinayana also we come from Theravada as the Mahayana as the Northern Buddhism. At that time, they go two ways. As now you can see in China and like Korea, Japan, they are also Mahayana, most of them are Mahayana Buddhism. And Theravada Buddhism is also in Sri Lanka, Myanmar, Thailand, Laos, Cambodia, and some of in Bangladesh also. Yeah. So the main group is but Vajrayana Buddhism just a little in Tibet, you know. Yeah. They are also because the idea may be a little bit different, but the main goal is the same. Is to reach the higher happiness or nirvana in Buddhism they call nirvana. Yes. In Mahayana and Theravada, we are the way of wearing also may be different. And practice also and a little bit different. Because the Theravada is for the elder from the Buddha at that from the Thera, that is the disciple of the Buddha, and from that until now, this we call Theravada Buddhism. Is we follow the idea, Vada is the idea or opinion, the idea of the Thera or elder monks from the Buddha's time until now. But Buddhism, when we talk Buddhism, after that century in India, Theravada Buddhism very weak, almost disappeared, but remain in Sri Lanka. Now in Sri Lanka is developing about Theravada Buddhism. And in Thailand, Myanmar, so Cambodia, Laos, this country as the main Theravada Buddhism they are practicing. So our Theravada what we practice is we, the main is we practice to get inner peace, to calm down, to realize the what happened in our mind, because most of everybody has problems. So if you don't know how to solve the problem, is some of you may don't know. The way is that when we sit meditation, we try to see our mind, what happened. Just close our eye and we can see our mind performing. That is when you see it, you can see. And so what is question you want to know? Yeah.
What is your day like? What do you do during
the day? Oh, here. But when we come, I can say if in our country and here will be different. First, in our daily life for a Buddhist monk, first I will talk in our country, right? In Buddhist country, for Buddhist, right, their daily life, they are when we in the morning we pray, we worship, and after that we go for alms work. It means if we say the no. The normal way maybe you understand going on from is you can baking food. Because in this country,
but slightly difficult.
Different. When you go the Asian country, the Buddhist country, you will see that. In the morning, you will see Buddhist monk go and begging for the food. Because monk no business, no job. No, nothing, just practice and depend on people for the food. So we have to, in the morning, we have to bring some kind of bowl, a black bowl, and go begging, asking for food from house to house. And come back and we study about Buddhism, study scripture, something, and talking Dhamma, giving Dhamma talk to the people who needs, and in the evening also pray for the Buddha. Worship and sit meditation. For Buddhist monk, we taking food only 2 times in the early morning and 12 after mid afternoon before 12. After that, we don't eat or we don't eat anything. We if hungry, just drinking some juice or water. After 12, we don't go for asking food anymore. We just stay in the temple, and when people they need some, for example, if their house want to pray to blessing something and religious service, they come and invite us, and we go for them and blessing for them and chanting some blessing for them. So now during this day, we one house funeral, so they come and invite us in the evening. We have to go to that house and chanting priest for them. And here we are staying here, we no need we to go and begging in outside, just a devotee or lay people. They bring food from their house and come and offer us here at 11 o'clock morning.
How many of you live here?
Yes.
How many of you live
here? Here we have 3. We have 3 monks.
Who can be monk and how can one be a monk? And can girls be a monk?
Okay, girls, at the time of the Buddha, also at that time also have. But during this day, in Sri Lanka and Thailand, become a little bit bigger. Female also can become a monk. They are called Bhikshuni. In order to be a monk is at first at a 10 year or 11 or maybe 11 until 19
years old.
Yeah, they can become a novice beginner. When after 12 years can become a higher ordination or monk like us. So for me, I become a monk for the 16 years. After I was 20 years, and now I become a monk 16 years. So it means my age is how
36.
So how old I am now?
36.
Yes, 36, 37.
And monks can sleep on very comfortable beds.
Yeah, yeah. But